It's my dad.
This episode is really significant to our series because it's the first time that we're learning something more about Liz. Right now, her world has been pretty small. It's just her and her husband, so we're gonna, for the first time, meet another member of her family, her father, Sam.
I should have been honest with you from the get-go. I was trying to protect you.
That history is in itself mysterious because Red has some kind of connection to my father, and that's why he's here.
She deserves the truth.
I can't let you do that.
It is really part of the heart and soul of the show, is that everybody within this series is presenting themselves to be somebody that they're not. And so I think, you know, a lot of the characters are hiding things for either good or bad reasons.
I can only hope to love her and protect her as you have.
Obviously, Sam has a secret, and that secret is how he came to have Liz in his life, why he adopted her, why he cares so much about her, and that Red is willing to do everything in his power to protect that secret from Liz. When it comes to the point where Red kills Sam, he's doing it sort of as a mercy kill, and there's a lot of pain in that moment for him.
I want you all to know what an honor this has been.
General Ludd was based a lot on Anonymous, and Nathaniel Wolfe is a blacklister, unlike our previous blacklisters, who isn't, you know, disturbing and sort of bad to look at and makes you uncomfortable. Nathaniel Wolfe is someone that is charismatic enough to have followers. And just the idea that there can be a guy with access to the internet can essentially reach out to hundreds, millions of people. And with one message and with a couple of keystrokes, he has a bunch of followers that are willing to sort of do his bidding. Justin Kirk, I think, was sort of the perfect match to that character. And in scenes both in the airport, he needed to be able to talk to other people and be charming and fit in, and also be ominous when he was sending his manifesto to the post office.
Today marks the beginning of a war.
You're an informant now?
I said I need his new name.
The whole interaction with the plastic surgeon was a really fun scene to work on and talk about and write, because it was the first time that Liz acts like Red. Red is constantly surprising Liz and putting her on her toes, and this was the first time that Liz did that to Red.
Give it to me, or I'll have the Miami field office tear your practice apart faster than you can say tummy tuck.
She's stronger than she even thinks she is. She's not necessarily equipped for all of these circumstances in her life, but he knows that she's going to overcome what he's gotten her into.
They had to play these covers that she had created in the moment, and Red and Liz going back and forth and continuing it, I think, surprised them both. So it was comedic and I think fun to watch.
You roll over like a cockapoo wanting his belly scratched?
You said this guy was solid.
Solid? Shame on you, Abraham.
Mind if I sit?
Oh, go right ahead.
We keep describing it as like the money moment. And it's the scene that we wanted to see, that we think fans wanted to see. And with Tom, we don't know if he's good, we don't know if he's bad, but they've never had a scene together.
There's nothing better than a fun villain, than a charming villain, you know? It's because villains don't have to play by the rules. And there's nobody better to play it than James Spader.
He'll always be there with her, watching all those who get close.
They're having this coded conversation, and it's also a warning to Tom about Liz and protecting her and making sure that she's not in harm's way, and sort of alluding to the fact that if Tom isn't who he says he is, you know, Red is going to be right there to step in and intervene. And if you've been watching the show all along, you would have picked up on the fact that at the end of the episode with Wu Jing, Red is given a number, and you don't know how it's going to be used, and finally we sort of pay that off at the end of this episode. And if you keep watching, you'll figure out how it all sort of puzzle pieces together. We are very excited about next week's episode. I think usually the way that the show sort of works is that it's Red and Liz in danger, or Liz and Wrestler, and this is the first time where everyone that you sort of know and love is going to be put in harm's way.